Hello everyone. Today's topic is care of the normal newborn. What is a normal newborn? A normal newborn is an infant born at 37 week completed gestation or roughly 9 month completed, or a baby with a birth weight 2.5 kg or more, or baby is not received any resuscitation during the delivery and his apgar is 1 minute apgar is 7 and above, and baby is not having any post delivery problems like any breathing difficulty, hypoglycemia or sepsis requiring NICU admission, or the mother is not having any antenatal problems like diabetes mellitus, any antepartum hemorrhage, maternal illnesses like Rh isoimmunization. So how we care a normal newborn? Immediately after delivery, the initial care given in the labor room, baby will be shifted to the mother in the mother's room in a warm linen, sterile linen, and baby is kept with the mother for 24 hours in the room. This is called rooming in. Instead of keeping nursery, baby will be kept mother. What is the advantage of rooming in? The rooming in helps the baby mother bonding to establish early and will prevent cross infections, and the rooming in help in early establishment of lactation. Then comes breastfeeding. Every mother is trained physically and emotionally and motivated for breastfeeding during the pregnancy period itself. The breastfeeding can be started half an hour to 1 hour after delivery. The milk secreted initially, called the yellowish thick milk, it is called colostrum. This colostrum is rich in energy, protein, micronutrients, immunological substances and cellular elements. All babies should get the benefit of colostrum. The physiological inadequacy that is seen in the initial few days, the first 3 days of breastfeeding, will not affect a normal newborn baby. So the normal newborn doesn't require any artificial feeding during this period. Exclusive breastfeeding is advised in the first 6 months of life. Even no water is required to give the baby during the first 6 month period. There is good weight gain is documented in exclusively breastfed babies. How we can measure the adequacy of this breastfeeding? The adequacy can be found out whether the baby is gaining weight 30 gram per day, and his baby is after a good feed, baby is sleeping for 2 hours minimum, and baby is having a urine output 6 times and more, it's called adequate breastfeeding. And babies require a proper burping after breastfeeding to prevent regurgitation of feeds. Then comes the bathing of babies. And the bathing initial few days when the baby is in the hospital, preferably we avoid bathing of the baby to prevent surface infections. But the second day onwards, baby can be given a sponge bath with lukewarm water, and baby will be given a complete bath once the cord is fallen and dried off. Then comes the care of the umbilicus. Initially, the umbilical stump is in the first day examined for any bleeding manifestations from the umbilical stump. Then onwards, there is no need of any application of medicine in the umbilical stump. The cord will fall off by 5 to 10 days of life, and any swelling, any redness in the umbilicus and any granuloma after falling of the stump requires immediate medical care. Then comes immunization. What are the vaccines given in the birth? The BCG and hepatitis B are given immediately after or before discharge from the hospital. Further vaccinations will be started from the second month of life and is continued as per the schedule of the National Immunization Program. Then comes the weight recording of the baby. A normal newborn baby, initial 3 to 4 days, there will be a loss of weight of 4 to 8% is accepted. This weight loss will be compensated by the end of the first week and baby will gain the birth weight. Further, the weight gain will be 30 gram per day in a normal newborn, 30 gram per day in the first 4 months, and the next 4 months it will be 20 gram per day, and the last 4 months of the year will be 10 gram per day. So roughly the birth weight will double by 4 to 5 months of life and triple by 1 year of life. Before I conclude, I'll explain few danger signs in a normal newborn which is requiring immediate medical care. The danger signs in the baby are: 1, any feeding difficulty, any lethargy, poor feeding or excessive cry, and then any bleeding from any side requiring immediate care, then any breathing problems like fast breathing, chest indrawing, retractions, then baby is stopping in between breathing called apnea or cyanosis, then comes other problems are any baby not passed meconium within 24 hours of life, or baby is not passed urine within 48 hours of life, immediate attention is required. Then further danger signs are any yellowish discoloration noted on the first day. This is called the pathological jaundice, or any deepening of jaundice in the subsequent days, in the, especially in a setting of Rh negative mother or OA or OB setting, needs medical attention. And further things are any hyperthermia, that is a fever or high temperature, or hypothermia or low temperature also require immediate medical attention. Here I conclude. Thank you.